Thank you so much. I'm actually really excited to be back. So, welcome everyone. Thank you for having me. Thank you, Candy. So when I was doing research about Legally Blonde, I realized I don't wear pink. I have a lot of blue. Not really my realm. But I like funny lawyer stories. So I was looking at like Judge Judy, Judge Judy fanfiction. It started getting weird. Off Judge Judy fanfiction. That was a whole lot happening. Anyway, so I was doing some research and found this weird story. But it's like a news article. It's from Houston, well, like a sub article of the Houston Press about a lawyer suing this individual for a bad Yelp review. And I was really high when I was reading it, so I thought it was the funniest shit ever. But I thought I'd share this little moment in history of when a lawyer decided to sue back. So, when 20-year-old Lim K was in a car accident this summer, it was a bad situation. Driving home at 1 a.m. just from a waitressing shift, K was clouded by an This isn't a fan fiction, no, I swear. She was clouded by a driver and broke two lower bones in her lower back. Unsure how to navigate the car insurance, expenses, etc., and to prove her damages, she reached out for legal help. As we do a Legally Blonde, she comes to the lawyer. Oh my god! Anyway, the help she got was less than satisfactory. The lawyers from, I mispronounce this, Tuan A. Ku law firm ignored her contacts and even at one point came into her bedroom while Kay was sleeping in her underwear. Seriously, she said. It was super unprofessional, as she wrote on Facebook. The firm maintains it was invited by Kay's mother. Okay, yeah. I see you laughing, but you're enjoying this story. where am I? Anyways, so she also took to Yelp to warn others about her bad experience. This led to a bunch of threatening emails from the law firm and from the attorney, Keith Newell. If you do not remove these posts from Facebook and other social medias, my office will have to take offense and file a lawsuit, he told her, according to a report in the Houston Press about the saga. Young and his associates went ahead and filed that lawsuit, demanding the young woman pay $100,000 to $200,000. Yeah, right? Dude? Hey, cool. And that was more than 100 times like what she had in her bank account. Same. Well, maybe 1,000 more. Anyway, for millennium. Anyway, so I feel like they're trying to pull every single penny out of me just because I didn't want to be their client, she said to the Houston Press. Kai was working 6 days a week to pay off through nursing school at Houston Community College. Okay, now he's a attacking student, so I am personally offended. We're broke as hell! Sorry, I'm getting hot though. Anyways, Noam said he didn't feel bad about suing her at all. I feel sorry for her, but I gave her plenty of opportunities for her to retract and delete her post, and she refused. Oh, bitch. Side note, I actually have a Yelp review about me. I just found out the other day. I used to work at a bakery, and apparently I was a sassy little kid who doesn't know how to communicate well, and yet my supervisor was like, I saw you talking to her. You were perfectly fine. So, 2 out of 5 stars for sassiness. Anyway. She did not remove the review. Instead, she fought back against the firm, and she got a new attorney, Michael Flemings, who took the case pro bono. Yeah. Round of applause for pro bono. Am I right, guys? We love free stuff. Fleming filed a motion arguing that first and foremost, Kai's social media complaints were true. Second, she couldn't do much damage to the reputation of the firm that had already had multiple poor reviews. Okay, law firm, I see you. I emoji. He argued that the lawsuit was a clear slap, a strategic lawsuit against public participation. Like many other states, Texas has allowed for slap suits to be thrown out of the court in the early stages of litigation. Texas work. Ultimately, the judge did throw out the case and agreed with Foreman. and the firm had to pay about $26,000 in attorney fees. Work. That's awesome, actually. We are happy with the judge's correct ruling in this case, Funding told IRS via email. Texas law specifically protects folks who are exercising freedom of speech on that. And the statute approximately applied in this situation. People should be free to express their opinions without fear of a lawsuit. Okay. I just don't think they should have sued her, Jesus. It's like, you were a bad law firm. The law firm hasn't replied for comments. In the end, Kai Saga will be one for the warning books. For anyone seeking limit to U.S. consumer rights, whether that be online or offline. The freedom of speech part started to scare me a little, and I was like, okay, it saved itself. And that's my fun story I found online, guys. My second half, if you have an extra piece of paper, please turn it around and write your worst breakup story, whether that you broke up with someone, they broke up with you, maybe it was mutual, but please write that and give that to me during intermission, please, because it would really help with my next piece.